linear programming problem we are going to discuss today. And in the linear programming, we will first discuss about the graphing and inequality. How we are going to put inequality into the graph paper, and how you are going to find the area depending on inequalities. As you know that in inequalities, there are three symbols we are normally using, that is greater than, equal to, and less than. And there are two other symbols which we are using, that is greater than equal to and less than equal to. When it is equal to, that is called equality. When it is greater than or equal to, less than or less than equal to, that time we will call it inequality. Let's start with this solution. First introduction, what is going to do there? What does the solution set look like when we are faced an inequality in two variables? We will see that it is a set of order pairs best represented by the shaded region, and recall the general form of any linear inequality in two variables is ax plus by less than c, in which a, b cannot both be 0, and the symbol less than can be replaced with greater than, less than equal to, or greater than equal to. Some examples like y less than minus 2x plus 6, x minus 2y greater than 0, or 2x minus 3y greater than equal to x plus 5y. As was the case with an equation, the solution set of a linear inequality in two variables is a set of order pair of real numbers. So what you need to know, the order pair of real number values that you are going to collect. However, in this case, the linear inequality will find that the solution set will be all the points in entire region of the plane called half plane. Let us consider this following inequality, that is y less than equal to minus 2x plus 3. Slope intercept form is y equal to mx plus b. Here y less than equal to minus 2x plus 3. So slope is m equal to minus 2, and y intercept, that is b equal to 3. If you are going to put into graph paper what are the points, pair of points we are getting, minus 1, comma 5, 0, comma 3, 1, comma 1. So you can draw a straight line. Now if we are going to find its gradient value, or you can say slope value, that you know that is rise by run. The values, if you are going to get it, rise by run, you will get it is minus 2, which is the value of m. Let's first think about the equal to part of the equal inequality. When graphing inequalities in one variable, we would draw a circle around the value and shade the circle because it is included in inequality. With equation in two variables, we don't have a point, we have a line. We treat the line in a similar fashion by bolding the line to denote that every point on the line is included in the inequality. In other words, every x and y value on the line will make the inequality statement true. Now we have to think about the less than part of the inequality. For inequalities of one variable, we would shade a line. In this case, we will need to shade a region on one side of the line. Intuitively, if we wanted to shade a region less than the line, we should shade the region to the left under or under the line if it is less than. Most of the time, the region below the line will be less than and the region above the line will be greater than. Let's shade the region below the curve. Now you are going to see the curve. Notice it was less than, so blue color region is the shaded region, what you can see over here. Note that inequality had been x plus y greater than 0, then a dashed line would have been used to show that the point on the line do not satisfy the inequality. if it is greater than, then it will be right side or above side region. For the practice test, you can take these inequalities and try by yourself in a graph paper, and I think it will help you to do your task. There are so many activities, even the graph portion is also provided. You can try these situations, and you can draw the shaded region for these inequalities. Few more inequalities also provided here, and it is a number line inequality. Graphing the solution after getting the values, how you are going to plot in the number line, that some problems are given over here. You can practice those problems. There are several more problems are here, and such a great inequality is how you are going to draw it, how you are going to solve it, and how you are going to plot it in number line, that is given over here. Practice this equations. All the best. Have a good day.